We want to solve the given quadratic equations using square roots. To do this, we want to isolate the x squared and then square root both sides of the equation. So to solve 8x squared equals 648, the first step is to divide both sides of the equation by 8. 8 divided by 8 is equal to 1, so now we have x squared on the left side of the equation. And on the right side, we have 648 divided by 8. 8 times 8 is 64. Difference here is 0. Bring down the 8. There's 1, 8, and 8. Remainder is 0. So our quotient is 81. So now we have x squared equals 81. Now we want x, not x squared. So to undo this squaring, we're going to square root both sides of the equation. But remember, when doing so, we are going to have plus or minus square root 81 on the right side. Well, the square root of x squared is equal to x. The square root of 81 is equal to 9, since 81 is equal to 9 times 9, or 81 is a perfect square. So we have x equals plus or minus 9. Or if we want to, we can write x equals negative 9, or x equals positive 9. Looking at our second example, notice how the x squared is already isolated, so we can just take the square root of both sides of the equation as the first step. So we have the square root of x squared equals plus or minus the square root of 75. So on the left side, the square root of x squared is just equal to x. But notice on the right side, 75 is not a perfect square, but we do need to identify the perfect square factors of 75 to simplify the square root. One nice way to do that is to look at the prime factorization of 75. So 75 is equal to 25 times 3. 25 is a perfect square factor because it's equal to 5 times 5. So just to show the work here, we can write 75 as 5 times 5 times 3. Here's the perfect square factor of 75 that's going to simplify. The 3 is going to stay underneath the square root. So our solution is x equals plus or minus. These two factors simplify to one factor of 5 outside the square root, and the 3 stays underneath the square root. So we have x equals plus or minus 5 square root 3, or if we want, x equals negative 5 square root 3, or x equals positive 5 square root 3. Okay, I hope you found these two examples helpful.